More evidence of the deep and growing divide on the Wisconsin Supreme Court. Late last week, the court split on whether to discipline fellow Justice Michael Gableman for this ad during his 2008 campaign.
Lewis Butler worked to put criminals on the street, like Reuben Lee Mitchell, who raped an 11-year-old girl with learning disabilities. Butler found a loophole. Mitchell went on to molest another child.
The ad referred to then-Justice Lewis Butler's work as a public defender. What it didn't say is that the suspect reoffended after being paroled and that Butler had nothing to do with his release. Justices Abrahamson, Crooks, and Walsh Bradley say Gableman committed judicial misconduct by knowingly making false statements. Justices Ziegler, Rogensack, and Prosser call the ad distasteful but say it's protected by the First Amendment. The High Court is also divided on how or even whether to proceed with the case. The justices were able to come together and unanimously close the book on one case, the state's constitutional ban on gay marriage and civil unions. The court ruled the constitutional amendment was properly put to voters in a statewide referendum 4 years ago. William McConkie, who has appeared on this program, filed a lawsuit claiming the amendment was actually two questions, one about gay marriage and one about civil unions. He believes the result would have been different had it been worded as two separate items. Justice Gableman wrote after the ruling that amendments can contain multiple propositions as long as they carry out one general purpose and are connected with one subject. Although he can't appeal the ruling, McConkie says he's not finished with this fight, saying there could be new cases and new legislation in different courts. A bold plan to stop Asian carp from invading Lake Michigan is moving forward. There will be a Senate hearing in Washington July 14th, where we'll hear more about the possibility of permanently separating the waterways that link the Mississippi River and the Great Lakes. Instead of passing through the current network of canals and rivers, boats and barges might one day use massive boat lifts, for example, to bypass the barricade. The costs and workability of such a plan are unknown, and that's why several lawmakers want a study of the idea. Biologists fear the giant carp, which can grow to 4 feet long and 100 pounds, could destroy the Great Lakes' $7 billion a year fishery by starving out native species. UPFRONT is back with a final word after this.
UPFRONT is produced with editorial assistance from WizPolitics.com, an online public affairs news magazine and resource on public policy issues.